Back for more? Doug Stewart with IT Creations. I did say I'd provide some benchmarks on the Intel Core i9-14900K CPU and the NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada with 48 gigabytes of DDR6 memory installed in the Dell Precision 3680 Workstation Tower. So here we are again. By the way, if you would like to see the hardware overview for the Dell Precision 3680, then click that link right there. Maybe a quick follow-up with the subscribe button. I know, too soon to tell. How about... Let's just jump right in. First, a recap of the system configuration of the Dell Precision 3680 Workstation Tower and a little more information about that CPU and GPU. The Intel Core i9-14900K CPU has 24 physical cores and 32 virtual threads. That includes 8 P cores and 16 E cores. For those graphics and rendering stress tests, the CPU is using the P cores for the gaming experience and the E core for background tasks to free up those P cores to deliver on the gaming experience. I'll also mention a base frequency of 3.2 GHz and a maximum turbo frequency of 6 GHz. In addition, the system was outfitted with 2 1TB NVMe M.2 drives, clearly only using one for this test, and 2 DDR5 32GB registered ECC DIMMs that can operate at a speed of up to 5600 megatransfers per second. The CPU is capable of supporting that memory speed, but I will say error correcting code on the memory is not going to do us any favors for the gaming experience. The NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada is not really a gaming card. Anyways, it's more for reliable performance for professional workstation applications. Here I will add air quotes, to meet the challenges of today's AI-driven workflows. Not blowing up any virtual enemy hideouts and alien warships. We use Cinebench R23 to test the Intel Core i9-14900K CPU on rendering that cute, sunny little breakfast nook. For the multi-core portion, it took about 21 seconds and a high score of 36,668. I won't bore you with the single core test other than to say it took about 6 minutes, which was actually pretty good. But again, do you want to watch grass grow? Looking for a CPU or maybe a GPU? Try IT Creations. We've got those and much more, including that little Dell Precision 3680 Tower workstation. Click that link right there to do a little window shopping at IT Creations. It's better than death scrolling. Next, we benchmarked the NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada generation GPU with 48 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. It has a base clock of 915 MHz with a boost clock of 2,505 MHz. We definitely hit those extremes, but we'll get to that in a minute. Yes, the naming on this card sucks, as I already had to edit this video because I mistakenly said RTX A6000 instead of RTX 6000 Ada, but Ada did follow the Ampere architecture, so we have to live with that. I mean, it could have been the RTX AG6000. Well, that sucks too. Let's move on. Surprisingly, this system was outfitted with top-of-the-line CPU and GPU. We don't always get the fun toys to play with. Anyways, we used the 3D Mark application, specifically Speedway, TimeSpy Extreme, and Port Royale. Kinda wish we had done the DLSS stress test at that point, but too late now. Tragically, the system is already gone. Nothing stays around here for very long. And I can say without a trace of sarcasm, we never get to keep the fun toys. Speedway is a stress test for reliability, stability, and sustained performance of your system. By the way, that's 3D Mark's description. This stress test also measures real-time ray tracing, ray traced reflections, real-time global illumination, mesh shaders, volumetric lighting, particles, and post-processing effects for high-end gaming PCs. Beyond that, as specified, we do have a high-end gaming card up to 6 gigabytes of video memory and support for DirectX 12 Ultimate. And there you have it. As I was reviewing the video on my system, the rendering itself looked excellent, but the video playback was a bit choppy until I came to a realization. It may be the graphics card on my system that's causing this crappy playback. I mean, it is a 4K video after all. I made the window smaller, tiny in fact, and had no playback issues. Very smooth in fact. What video card do I have in my system, you may be asking? It's an NVIDIA Quadro M6000, released in 2015 and installed in my old workstation, also circa 2015. So old. As I can attest, technology never ages well. Numbers. The NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada generation offers legendary performance at 7,765 points and 77 frames per second. Speedway also recognized the CPU does support integrated Intel UHD graphics 770, but in this case, we are just using the discrete RTX 6000. Looking at those color-coded lines, purple at the top indicates the CPU is definitely hitting that maximum turbo frequency of 6 GHz, consistently. That next line in yellow is the GPU memory clock frequency hitting about 2.5 GHz, which is consistent with the specs for the GPU. There was no information available for the relative frame rates this card might render for a number of games. Battlefield 5, Apex Legends, GTA 5, Red Dead Redemption 2, and Fortnite. Here you can see the basic information of our test platform, the 3680 Tower. Pause if you want to read all the specs. More granular information on the various monitoring starting at the top. Frame rates, temperature, percentage of GPU to CPU load, and then frequency in megahertz for the CPU clock and then GPU memory and GPU clock. For temp, the GPU showed a clear increase in temperature over the relatively short stress test of about 27 degrees Celsius. Moving on. We used TimeSpy Extreme to measure the performance, which measures for a 4K UHD monitor, which is what we have. Not that you need one for this test. This module starts off with a demo portion. There are two graphics tests here, followed by a CPU test at the end. Test one looking at transparent content particles, shadows, and tessellation, which creates increased detail by creating smaller polygon shapes from the 3D objects. Graphics test two looks at ray-marched volumetric illumination using hundreds of lights and floating particles. I will say the particles are not what I would consider volumetric particles, more like fireflies. They're huge. All of it rendered pretty well, I thought. Keeping in mind, this is not a GeForce gaming card, but designed more for scientific simulations and rendering data and CAD applications. Can you use this for gaming? Thankfully, yes. With all the same graphics and tests from a few years back, at this point, do you think the 3D Mark applications is getting a little long in the tooth? Add your comments below. Although, to be fair, some of the comments I have received have mentioned other applications for testing. That said, there are definitely other channels that go in depth on this, and our focus is primarily the whole system, not so much the bits. And I'm lazy. Again, for TimeSpy Extreme, this card received legendary performance with a point count of 13,522, plus some crazy high frame rates for the assorted games. Moving on to the monitoring graph, CPU clock frequency at the top in purple, yellow for GPU memory clock frequency, and red for the GPU load percentage. Definitely a few fluctuations that probably correspond to slower action segments. Next, you can see the system information, but that hasn't changed, so rewind the video if you want to see that information. Lastly, the more granular results, which you should pause if you want to view in more detail. Next, Port Royale. Port Royale tests real-time ray tracing in DirectX, basically reflections, shadows, glass surfaces, volumetric lighting, particles, and a lot of the same stuff that gets tested in the other modules. Let's take a look. Definitely has a zombie apocalypse feel to it, and there is a lot going on in this module. Visually, very interesting and running at a very high frame rate between low 90s and upper 70s. The rendering itself looks fantastic, but again, a high-end card and CPU. Let's watch for a minute. You can also use the benchmarks in the description below to go to specific sections if you want to skip ahead or back. And the results. Again, legendary performance with a score of 17,913 ROUS points. That would be the acronym for my made-up name for the score, Raster Output Under Stress. Not to be confused with rodents of unusual size.
Rodents of unusual size? I don't think they exist.
Anyways, 17,913 with an average frame rate of 83 frames per second. Sorry, no data available for frame rates on other games, but I can only assume they would be quite high too. Would be better if it said something like, smoking fast. As you can see with that purple line, the CPU is getting a workout with peak frequencies of up to 6,000 megahertz or 6 gigahertz to conform to the unit of measure I provided at the beginning of this video. That yellow line indicates GPU memory clock frequency in megahertz, and the pinkish line, the GPU clock frequency, also in megahertz. And indeed, we are hitting the top frequencies of about 2,505 megahertz supported on this card for that legendary performance. Keep in mind, there is no overclocking on this card. Still, legendary performance. You can see there is the integrated graphics provided by the CPU, but that is not being measured at the moment. On the granular graph scale, you can see some impressive performance on the frame rates. Next, the temperature does increase as the test progresses, but it does level off. Next, on the percentage of use, we are getting maximum effort out of that GPU at 99%. That frequency graph at the bottom is the same as the one at the top, and we already looked at that, so that concludes our test results for today. Not entirely comprehensive, but if you want more, there is more to be found on performance values. That said, how much do you really need to determine if a card is worthy? Add a comment below. I would truly love to know. Could be my attention span is just too short. I don't know. Anyways, a pleasure reading the comments, for better or worse. If you want more information on this card, you can click that link right there or one in the description below. We have this GPU, CPU, and that little Dell Precision 3680 tower. So check out IT Creations if you're shopping around. ITCreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Steumann with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.